back out here in range for another video. Finally got my chronograph fixed. Look at that guy. Man, after the last poor incident.
460 Magnum.
Anyway, so what we're going to do today, I just had a bunch of 22s sitting around, different types. And I just won this 5.7. I really like it. It shoots good. It's a lot of fun. But the problem is, these are the Federals. So they're 40 grains. And I think they're 1,700 feet, 1,800 feet, right around there. We'll test it. So 1,700 feet a second, okay? About, if you get them on sale, $40 a box of 50, okay? 22 Magnum, box of 50, 15 bucks. Camera won't focus, but that says 1,875 feet a second. So 22 and a 40 grain bullet, same bullet, both 22 caliber. That's half the price going faster. Now, I don't think they make a semi-auto 22 mag pistol, but that'd be pretty cool if they did, because it's literally half the price, and you can buy, I bought this ammo at Walmart, you know, so a lot more available, a lot cheaper, and same bullet. Now, if these, you get the blue tip, they go 23, 24, but they're, I think, only 26 grain, and the armor piercing rounds, are they 20 grain? They're solid steel, but you can't really get them. They go close to 3,000 feet a second, but you can't really get them. They're hard to find. They're very expensive if you do. So what I'm gonna do, I got my chronograph up. We're gonna do some velocity first. And oh, and these are caps, I think. If anybody knows, let me know for sure, because back in the day, I had a bunch of them. They have 22 short, okay? And then they have caps, but I think the CB is the newer version of the cap. It's almost just like a primer charge in them, but these say 710 feet per second. They're supposed to be really quiet, 29 grain. I can't remember if these are just the subsonics, but I think the CBs are the caps, so we'll try them out. But if anybody knows for sure, because I know back in the day I had the subsonics, they were quiet, but then I had caps that were, I mean, you could, it sounded like a BB gun going off, and I used them in the yard for chipmunks and stuff, and that's actually what they're meant for, is just shooting rodents in the yard, so not loud and not dangerous or anything. So I got my Magnum cylinders. I set my camera up there so we can read the chronographs at the same time, and yeah, and then we'll do maybe a water jug penetration test between the 22 mag and then the 5.7. Maybe we'll do some other wood or something.
What's that? Skinwalker.
Okay, I was going to try to keep my camera up there, but it was kind of, I only had two tripods, so I'll just tell you what the numbers are. I was practicing. One of them caps was 657, so I got a cap, a regular 22, and then these are velocitors. They're gold dots, hollow points. They work really good. I mean, you could use a 22 for self-defense, and should be capped there, and if you put these hollow points in there, man, I'm telling you, they'll work. Okay, that was 657. This should be a regular 22. I think these are high velocity though. Definitely louder. And of course, it didn't work. Let me reset my thing. Okay, for some reason, I don't know. I was trying to figure out right where it needed to be with the chronograph, but you know, let's see here. This is a regular 22. 1,000 feet a second. I really wish I would have brought some hearing protection. Yeah, this is a velocitor. It's a 1076. We'll switch to the Magnums. Okay, next up we got the 22 Magnum. We'll see what kind of velocity it has. Let me put my... Alright. Man, the difference. That was 1,400 feet a second. Okay, now I'm going to try the Rough Rider. This has a 16-inch barrel. It's still not working right, so if anybody has any idea. One thing nice about these, that the cylinder is actually rifled. I know John from Alloy 211 said that when he put his Magnum cylinder in, it worked. So actually, this is the first time I'm trying it. So let's see how it works. .1276, that was slower. An amount of gunpowder it came back. .1179, not that impressed. There's a misfire. .1184. .1184. I'm gonna go for that guy over here. Of course. All right. Need one more in there. All right, so I got 6 more loaded up in the Ruger. I don't know why the bigger barrel. It's only going about 1,200 feet a second. But this is what the Rough Rider's doing. It won't fucking focus. All right, so this is what the Rough Rider's doing. Can't really see, but it strikes the primer. Just doesn't go off. Anyway, I got 6 more loaded up in the Ruger. I don't know why they're only getting like 1,200 feet a second. Box is 18, even with a 16-inch barrel, man. Didn't make a difference. .1387. I mean, it's faster out of a shorter barrel. .1389. .1344. Let's go for the Crow. Oh, just missed them. Yeah, I mean, it's only 1350, so let's try 5.7. Okay, so I got 3 rounds, 40 grain, and a Smith & Wesson M&P 5.7. Let's see what she does here. Yeah, it says 1636. 1620. One more. 1562. So she's definitely shooting faster than a 22 mag. So we'll try some penetration tests now. Okay, first up, we're going to do a 22 cap, or CB, the short, whatever they are. I don't think we'll go through these two, but I don't know. Let's see. A little close here, but. Okay, that was kind of surprising, man. She went blazing straight through both of them. And right there's the exit, and see it hit right here. And actually went into a 2x6. And next up is a 22 Magnum. Yeah, before we lose all the water, we'll try 5.7. Might back up a little on this one. Okay, well, the 22 mag definitely had some energy. I think we stopped both of them. It was 22, 5.7, went through more. So it stopped on the third one. And a 5.7 just punctured it. And now there's two holes. There are two exit holes. Yeah, so they both went through the same. One came out the back though. They both came out the back. Yeah, they both, yep. Huh, I did not know that. I thought it stopped it. So. Yeah, 22 mag and a 5.7 are very close to the same. And 5.7 edges it out just a little bit. And it's a little bit more fun, but 22 mag is literally half the price. So if you're just shooting pistols, I mean, 22 mag is the way to go. It's just cheaper. And about, I mean, honestly, I think the 22 mag, which one was it? Where's it at? Sorry, my phone's all glitchy if it's glitching on here. The 22 mag did this. The 5.7 just poked a hole. So, 22 mag. Especially if you get some hollow points and stuff. Them are just full metal jackets. Definitely better and cheaper, for sure. But the 5.7, it's fun to shoot, man. It really is. I really like that gun. It's so fun, just the mag dump and stuff. And it's expensive.